Please locate Judge C.R. Magny State Park in Minnesota, USA, on the north shore of Lake Superior. Judge C.R. Magny State Park in Minnesota, USA, on the north shore of Lake Superior.
The name again.
Judge C.R. Magny State Park, Minnesota, USA.
Yes, we have the place.
Please locate in this area, about 1.5 miles from the mouth of the Brule River, a waterfall called the Devil's Kettle. This location is nicknamed the Devil's Kettle. It's about 1.5 miles from the mouth of the Brule River, next to a waterfall. This waterfall is unusual in that the eastern flow goes over a 50-foot waterfall and continues downstream. But this area is like a cauldron or pothole that the water flows into and nobody knows where it goes. Again, the Devil's Kettle.
We have the place.
Okay. Again, the water flow surges into a cauldron or pothole, disappearing underground. Nobody knows where the water goes. Please examine and briefly describe where the water is flowing and where it ultimately ends up.
The mystery is not too extensive here. As we would find this, it would seem to parallel underground the same stream flow and then rise up again and join with the flow itself. That is to say, it seems to go along the ground and then come back up to the surface again, a little further away in the same direction as the flows, as the falls rather would face, only further along and under the ground. There's a large cavern here. It could be the size in which a man could progress along the waterway itself. It does seem to be similar to that you would call artesian well, so to speak. In the ground one place and out of the ground in another. There is no evaporation. The water does not seem to flood into the adjacent areas. The ground is quite porous. There are layered rock here, and this seems to migrate through these lower, or this tunnel that appears to be rusty color, or that there would be some deterioration of this stone, like limestone, all brown in color. It is not limestone, however. Direction?
Okay, in the past, people have tried to find out the origin of the mystery by placing colored dye in this area, the Devil's Kettle, and trying to see where it would end up. Why is this not revealed, where the water's going, if it's such a basic thing?
This would account for the stain on the stones that we are observing here. As we said, a rusty color. This is the dye being absorbed into the stones here. The problem being is it is a considerable distance, and that of the dye is somewhat absorbed into the stone, or the rock as you might call it, quite porous, or like a sponge that filters the water almost. However, the movement underground in the same direction is a considerable distance. Direction.
Okay, you say a considerable distance. About how many miles or meters, or about how far downstream?
Difficult to tell because of the the meandering under the water, under the ground rather, the water moves up and down and sideways. It is not a straight flow. However, if we would mark it, it would seem to be almost 100 miles, but we have something at 13 miles as well. Direction.
Briefly, what caused this place to form? What I'm getting at is, was it natural or man-made?
This would have been an old campground for those that would be the original peoples here. There was modification to the waterway, but it would be considered more of a natural form. The cliff in which the water flows from the top to the bottom was lifted up in antiquity, and almost like someone splitting the earth itself, it was pushed up. Therefore, you would find consistency between the upper rock and the lower rock. But here there were many, over time, camps, those that would wear the skins of the animals and would use those same skins to inflate, call them craft, with hot air, to those that would be more of the Native Americans, as you would call them, and to that there would be the early settlers itself, where this would be a good and steady supply of water, you'll say. The term devils comes from that, as to the plunging beneath the ground, and for the loss of life that has occurred here, for many have attempted to explore this and have disappeared, not to return ever, because of the movement on different occasions. The velocity of the water can be quite swift, and on others very mild or sluggish, depending on the season and the temperature, and frost, or that as to dampness, depending, in the surrounding area. Direction.